there is one thing that's remarkable about Fusion 360, it's that it's constantly changing. It comes with new updates month by month. Especially researchers of Fusion 360 are taking into account your feedback using Autodesk communities and forums. So, in this video, I'm actually gonna be sharing my 10 best tips that I choose for you, all about how to design fast and fun way. Let's get started.
Hi, this is Cengiz from Designwagoon channel. In this tutorial, we're going to reveal 10 tips that I think useful to use in Fusion 360. First of all, we can start with shortcut of constraints. I will draw 3 different lines to show you the tip. Well, if you select 2 of them while you are pressing Shift on the keyboard, you can see only proper constraints are selectable. The other way to select your constraint is right-click on the mouse. It will appear just proper constraints for your selection. Let's select the parallel, then easily apply for third line by clicking. Or, in another example, you can select 4 different circles at the same time. After you push the right-click, then you can easily select the equal. In this tip, I will show you depth face selecting, which is very handy in 3D workspace. Well, to do that, you should press the left click for a while. Then it will show up a tiny window and magic starts here. You can select easily all faces that intersect of the mouse cursor. Also, you can select all features that about the components as parents. So, I like to assign a fillet to the front face of clamp plate. After I select the face, I'm pressing F key to open the fillet tool. I will enter 2 mm for the edges of the clamp plate, then hit OK or Enter. The table-wise assembly works perfectly. So, you can use this tip any faces on your projects. In this tip, we will use a gripper assembly design for a robotic arm. Well, you can select a fillet feature or another tool that you want. Normally, we choose the edges that we want to modify, then enter the value. But after we assign a dimension, it's really hard to assign another edges. Maybe I can select this edge, but it immediately changed the value. So I remove the selection, set, and try again. I'm following the same steps again, but this time the tip is coming. I'm pushing and holding control button on the keyboard. Then magic starts again. So I'm adding the new edges. Well, it perfectly assigned at the same value. So there's another way in Fusion 360. You can select the add selection set button. Then you can assign easily new edges or faces that you want to modify. So I'm entering 2 mm and 1 mm for my selected edges. You can try on your own on the fillet feature or other features also. Well, this tip does not look like a tip. It's a very new tool in Fusion 360. But as I mentioned before, the software always getting updates and you can share your ideas via Autodesk forums. So, after you create an offset plane, you can change the dimension by pulling the vertices. I drew a sketch in this plane. You can use text tool to write something. Well, I'm selecting create emboss tool. Firstly, I'm selecting sketch profiles. Then I'm selecting the face that I want to use emboss tool on it. Voila, c'est magnifique. Well, of course you can change the depth value, position using the arrows, effect for the emboss or deboss and rotation of the profiles. In this tip, we're gonna use the power of 3D sketch. After you create a sketch in a plane or face, you can check the box for 3D sketch in the sketch palette. I draw a circle using the C key. Then I hit the L key to draw a line. Well, magic starts here. You can select a different plane on the manipulator. I'm selecting the YZ plane. Then I continue to draw in the 3D workspace. I'm drawing another line to another size, then I'm easily changing the plane. After all, I'm drawing a circle, then using the T key to open the trim tool. You can press S button to open sketch shortcuts. Then I'm selecting sweep tool. I'm selecting profiles and paths. In this way, I designed my components very fastly. In this tip, we'll take a look at the move copy tool. To do that, I'm creating a box. The dimensions aren't important. Well, normally, if you want to modify the shape, you can create new sketches, then use the extrude tools. But there is another way to modify the shape of this box. I'm selecting the move copy tool. Then choose the faces for move objects. Select the pivot point for the manipulator and rotate the selected face. As you can see, the shape changes, but using the move copy tool, it's really handy way. If you want to reopen your last tool, you can right click then select the repeat tool. Well, if you like to change the pivot of the manipulator, you can select set pivot, then select the control point that select the pivot tool again. Now you can modify the face as you want. Also, you can change the position of the face. Of course, move type tool has different types of manipulators. Well, it looks quite different than a classic box, right? In this tip, we will take a look at parametric design tools. Maybe you already use the parametric modeling techniques, but many Fusion 360 users don't know that there are useful parametric design techniques inside of Fusion 360. Well, I'm drawing a rectangle. Then hit the D key to define a dimension. Maybe I can enter 50 millimeters. For the second line of the rectangle, I will use the first dimension. Just select the dimension, then you can see the name, D1. Well, let's try to use some math. I will press the multiplication symbol on the keyboard to multiply the value by 2. As you can see, parametric designing works. Or we can press the splash key to divide the value by 2, I will multiply by 2 again. Everything works perfectly, so we can try it in 3D dimensions. I'm pressing the E key to use the extrude. Then I'm entering D1 as the same name, the first input dimension. As you can see, it works everywhere in 2D and 3D workspaces. So divide by 3. If you hit the FX function symbol, you can see the result value as millimeters, but I would like to use as parametric design. Also, you can use on the other tools. Perhaps we can try on the fillet. After you select the edges, you can assign the value as V1 divided by 5. Well, we can use the third tip as we talked. Press and hold the CTRL key, then select the new edges. So, if you like to change the input value, you can go back to Sketch or select the Modify, Change Parameters. You can find the Sketch and D1 value, so we can easily change the value as we want. The parametric design works perfectly. In this tip, we will change the type of design to solid and surface. You can quickly draw a box to do that. As you can see, there are different tabs on the top of the toolbar. I'm selecting the surface. Well, I know that the box is solid and full of the inside of it, but not in the surface. I'm selecting the face, then right click, delete. As you can see, the solid face is gone. It simultaneously creates a surface from a solid box. After I select the fillet tool, I'm selecting the selection filters and just check on the body edges. I'm selecting all edges rear of the box, then enter a value. Now you can use the Tikken tool to create a body from the surface. Now we have a body and surface in the bodies folder. To create this shape of body, you can also use the shell tool in the solid workspace. In this tip, we'll take a look at the Create Form tool. As you know, Fusion 360 has a T-Sublime modeling workspace, and there is numerous possibility to create amazing designs in the 3D software. So I'd like to show you the tip. Firstly, I'm creating a plane. You can increase the values of length and width faces. After you select the Modify Edit Form tool, you can manipulate the position of vertices. But as you can see, it's just the vertex. But there is another way to do that. You can select the Soft Modification. Then, as you can see, it's totally changed. You can change the weight value or the distance value. Also, after you change the transition type, you can see the results. Well, let's change the position of other vertices using the Soft Modification tool. As you can see, it's quite a simple and handy tool to create a very complex shapes in a couple of minutes. You can also use the surface in the solid workspace. Well, let's take a look at the generative design workspace.
All right. Yeah.
So, this project is part of the Autodesk University 2020. I created a hands-on lab at AU 2020 as creating a drone chassis using generative design. You can find the class on the Autodesk University website and the class link is below. In a short definition, generative design is a design exploration process. Designers and engineers input design goals into the generative design software, along with parameters such as performance or special requirements, materials, manufacturing methods, and cost constraints. The software explores all the possible permutations of a solution, quickly generating design alternatives. It tests and learns from each iteration what works and what doesn't. Well, after you set all the necessary steps, you can enter the Explore view to compare the generative design outcomes. I'm selecting outcome 1. As you can see, there is detailed information about the outcome, and you can also change the iteration number. You can create a design from outcome. As you can see, we are in the design workspace. You can modify the form of the shape created by generative design. Right-click the form feature and edit. Then select the Modify Cylinderify. You can easily select the face that you want to cylinderify. And you can also make the cylinder thicker using the manipulator. Well, I hope the 10 best tips tutorial will help with your projects. And if you have any questions about the Fusion 360 or 3D designing, please just drop a comment below. We are also creating interesting videos on the Instagram Designwagoon channel. You can also find the link below. If you'd like to see more tutorials about Fusion 360 and designing, subscribe to the Designwagoon channel on YouTube. Hope to see you next tutorials.